Hi, it's Josie. Some of you know me as Yoga Hippie. So before we start our practice today, just kind of setting our intention and what we're kind of manifesting in our practice and how we can connect to that. Of course, tying it into our lives and what we're all going through right now. And I saw an amazing thing yesterday talking about our verbiage. And I talk about this a lot in my classes of how powerful our thoughts are and how powerful our words are and how they're received. And so when we hear these terms like social distancing, it is very harmful to how we react to that because we do take things literally. And isolation and feeling alone is not what we need right now. So we hear social distancing and we automatically connect to being alone, completely detaching socially. Where if we can change that dialogue, and it's physical distancing, not socially distancing, it's time to kind of get rid of that term and hopefully change the verbiage into physical distancing, but don't socially distance yourself. This is the time to come together and do extra social stuff, give and reach out and be extra social in order to create this connection and bond and unity between us all and create more love, more light, and just more connection all around. So it's tying into that of just how powerful our thoughts are, how powerful those words are that we speak and how we receive them, and keeping in mind of how other people may receive them. So working today in our practice of really being calm and clear in our minds of what we're connecting to and how we are speaking to ourselves, and in return speaking to others as well. So today's practice, let's practice that social connection and within ourselves here on our mats, and then take that out into our day and apply it and reach out and be socially connected. Okay, so we're gonna get on our mats. So allowing your knees to be about mat width apart, big toes relax back, and then stretch and walk your hands forward, allowing your forehead and your heart to soften down. Even let your elbows drop down here. Opening up your cervical spine a little bit, relaxing, releasing by rocking your head from side to side. And then just allow your head to settle back into center. Giving yourself three deep cleansing breaths. Inhale. And sigh out as you let it go. Allow it to relax and calm your body, to clear and quiet your mind. Inhale. Exhale, let it go. And one more. Inhale. And let it go. And just softly swallow. Relax and clear your throat. Just breathing in and out through your nose. Take a moment to begin to set those very clear intentions. Again, knowing and understanding the power of every thought. Knowing your thoughts will become words, so be very clear and intentional on your thoughts, on your intentions. And just know that one positive thought or intention can alter and change the quality of the rest of your day. And with daily practice, it can change the quality of the rest of your life. Just softly begin to walk your fingertips a little bit further forward, allowing this to hover and lift your elbows up. And begin to walk your spine over towards the right side as far as you can go. Feel free to turn your left cheek down. Maybe that right arm sweeps back behind you. Take another deep full breath. And gently release, bringing it back to center. Pausing at center. If your hips or knees feel a little sensitive, you can shift forward for a second. Anchoring back, and then begin to walk it over towards the left side. Maybe turn your right cheek down. Maybe that left arm reaches back behind towards your right hip or inner thigh. One more big breath. And a soft beginning release, coming back to center. Once you come back to center, work your knees together underneath you, and then allow your forehead to ground down as you slide your arms back towards your feet. Just take a deep breath. And then slowly begin to roll your spine. Once you sit up nice and tall again, if this is too sensitive on your hips or your knees or maybe your ankles, it's okay to rise to your shins here. You're just gonna be slowly rolling your shoulders back. Exaggerate that. And then take in the opposite direction. And you always wanna leave your heart open, which means take an external rotation again, allowing your heart to be lifted and open. And then sweep your arms up. Interlace your fingertips, lift and press it, look up, arch your back. And as you exhale, press forward and lean back. So it's kind of a cat and cow motion. Inhale, reach and lift. Exhale, press forward as you round and pull back. Feel your navel pulling into your spine. Take it two more times. Inhale, exaggerate it. Exhale, round, push forward. One more. And exhale, round, pulling your navel back, push and reach forward. Inhale to a nice, tall, long spine. And as you exhale, release your hands and shake it out. Shake out your hands side to side. Even flop your wrists up a little bit. Wiggle out your fingers. And let's get started. Come to all fours, hands underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips. Activate. First, allow your hips to find a little bit of release by swaying them out from side to side. Knowing that the wider you sway, the deeper the hip stretch, maybe you pause and take a big breath. There's something else that your body kind of craves or needs right now, feel free to take it. Maybe it's those traditional cat and cows. Maybe it's more barrel rolls. Again, just tune into your body, see what it needs, getting connected to your body and your breath. And then settle back into center. Creating some core activation. So ground all 10 fingertips nice and firm. Tuck your toes under. And now just begin to hover your knees up. But don't let your butt stick up. Keep your shoulders on top of your wrists. Knees underneath your hips. And even feel your navel lifting up like you're tucking your tail a little bit. So again, you're not sticking your butt up, but you're tucking your tail and lifting your belly button in. Now feel like the crown of your head is trying to pull forward, but you don't actually go forward. Your hips are anchoring you back. For three. For two, let your knees gently come back down. Untuck your toes, send your heart forward, chin up. Exhale, round your spine, hollow out, lift your navel up. Inhale to a flat back. Keep your feet the same, press so firm to the tops of your toes that your knees lift up. Core activated, belly button up, shoulders back, neck long, three. For two, gently release your knees back down. Tuck your toes under. Gently begin to press your glutes back to your heels, sliding your hands back. And then just to release your wrists, turn your fingertips to face back towards your knees. Try to relax and soften your shoulders away from your ears. Know that the further you sit and lean back, the deeper the stretch. Can you feel your navel pulling in? Don't just drop your belly. Fingertips stay back, but you're gonna flip your palms to face up. And then try to straighten through the arms and rotate the crease of your elbows to face forward. Again, try not arching round. Feel your heart extending. Your spine is lengthening. Take another big breath. And then slowly begin to lean back to ease off your wrists. Wiggle out your fingers. Shake out your wrists once again. And then as you reach up to the arms, rise up, inhale. Exhale to all fours, nice strong core. Palms firmly grounded, lift your knees. Pull your hips back, lengthening out of your wrists, your arms, and your spine, and then begin to straighten through your legs. Feel free to walk it out here. You can bend at the knees, right to left, left to right. And separate your feet a few inches apart at least. Lift high your tiptoes. And as you exhale, drop both heels over to the right side. Can you create one straight line with the blades of your feet, pushing your hips up, chest back. And bring it back to center. And exhale, drop your heels over to the left, hips up, chest back. Relax your neck. And then inhale, bring it back to center. Exhale, soften your heels down and back. Inhale, lift high your tiptoes. And exhale, soften down and back, hold. Look gently over towards the right. And then to center. Gently to the left, then center, softly look forward, now look all the way back towards your belly button, inhale, gently look forward, exhale your chin towards your chest, eyes up towards your navel, now just relax your neck, take a deep belly breath in, side out, let it go. As you inhale, walk it forward to your high plank. Feel your heart reaching forward. Quads lifting up, knees lifting up, belly button lifting up, heart lifting up, throat lifting up. Inhale, stretch it forward, shift forward to your tiptoes. Exhale, lower all the way down to the ground, nice and controlled. Hips and heart ground at the same time. And then point your toes back as you inhale, lift your heart, Bhujangasana Cobra. And exhale, soften it back down. Hug your biceps in tight. Inhale, lift again. Activate your arms a little bit, maybe lift it a little bit higher. And then exhale, soften back down. And again, inhale, lift. Maybe you press so firm that your arms begin to straighten, but don't lift your hips, heart open. And exhale, roll it back down. Neck nice and long, so gaze down. Modified push-up, inhale, push-up. Tuck your toes, lift your knees, downward facing dog. Keep your feet and hands the same. Holding for three. For two, inhale, bring it forward, high plank. Always feel free to drop to your knees to modify, lower halfway down, chaturanga. Inhale to upward facing dog. Exhale, drop back, downward facing dog. For three, feel your hips pulling up higher. Base of your rib cage lifting up. Relax your neck. Inhale, rise up high, your tiptoes. Eyes forward, slowly with patience, begin to tiptoe forward. Every step is taken on purpose, with intention. And then once you arrive, ground down firm through your feet. Inhale, lengthen your spine halfway up. Heart extends forward, shoulders drop back. Exhale, bend your knees, round your spine, let it go, forward fold. Inhale, lengthen, lift halfway up. As you exhale, let it go, forward fold. One more time. Inhale, lengthen. Can you pause for a moment? Notice if your hips are further back, even if the legs are bent. Can you lean and shift into your toes? Reach your heart. Inhale. Exhale, forward fold. Heel toe your feet, almost mat width apart. And bend into your legs. Hold the opposite elbows and gently sway it out from side to side. Relax around your neckline, your shoulders. Coming back to center, take a big breath. Exhale, can you soften a little bit lower, a little bit heavier. Now bend deeper into your legs, more like a squat. Release your hands down to the mat. Legs strong, slowly push to roll your spine up. Once your heart slowly lifts, roll your shoulders back a couple times. And then palms facing forward. So you're in Tadasana as you heel toe your feet together. So you're standing wide, and then heel toe your feet together. Inhale, reach your arms up high. As you exhale, just bring your arms to your hips, hands to the hips. You're gonna cross your right leg in front of the left. So your inner thighs are together nice and tight. Make sure that that right hip doesn't move forward. Use your hands to help pull that right hip back. Take an inhale. As you exhale, you're gonna slowly hinge and forward fold. You can bend your knees if you need to. Be gentle on your hamstrings. And then gently release your hands down. Relax your neck. Press firm into your big toes. You want your feet as flat as possible. Feel your right hip pulling back. You can add on here to progress. Left hand goes behind to the left calf or ankle. A little bit of balance. Right hand you interlace. Maybe begin to pull and forward fold. Hold for three. For two. Hands to your hips. Core engaged. Bring your spine halfway up. As you exhale, stand and rise. Inhale, reach your right arm out now. As you exhale, begin to lean. If you don't need the left hand at your hip, slide it down. Don't close off your heart and your hips. Draw it back, open up. Power into the big toe sides of your feet. Feel your inner thighs and pelvic floor hugging into your midline. Maybe begin to turn your gaze up. Stretch out whole right side for three. Maybe come down a little bit deeper, right hip back. And then eyes forward. Inhale, reach and lift back up. Exhale, your arms down by your sides. Just release the right foot. Readjust. And then cross your left foot in front of the right. Again, notice how that left hip wants to turn back. So bring your hands to your hips. Pull your left hip back so the hips are facing forward. Press firm to the big toes. Take an inhale. And as you exhale, slowly begin to hinge and forward fold. Reach your heart forward. It's okay to bend at your legs. And at that deepest point, release your hands down. Give yourself a second. Notice again how the hips are going to want to sway and close off. Pull your left hip back. Reach your heart forward as much as you can. And then maybe hinge and forward fold a little bit more. If you want to play with that progression, a little bit of more balance and stability, right hand reaches the back of your right calf. Even more so, left hand interlaces with it, and then gently pull and forward fold, chin reach into your shin. Push back with your quads, shoulders high to your hips for three. Big breath. Slowly slide your hands up to your hips. Bring your spine halfway up as you inhale. Pull your hips back. Squeeze, engage. Exhale, stand and rise. Reach your left arm out now. As you exhale, begin to lean over toward that right side. Again, feel free to slide your right arm down. Pull your left hip and left shoulder back. Engage. Feel the ground beneath your foot. Root down. Maybe turn your gaze up. Breathing for three. Strong arms, strong legs, eyes forward. Inhale, slowly bring it back up. And exhale, release your arms out and down. Gently release that left leg. Come back to your Tadasana, big toes together, heels slightly apart. Standing tall, heart lifted and open. Take a deep, intentional breath. Sigh out, let it go. Inhale, reach and lift and look up. Exhale, forward fold. Notice how much better this forward fold feels. Inhale, lengthen halfway up. Align your fingertips with your toes, and you're going to reach and step your right and then your left foot back, finding your plank. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale to upward facing dog. Exhale, drop back, downward facing dog. Hold for three. Feel like you're really pulling your hips up towards the ceiling for two. Inhale, reach your right leg up. Exhale, step it forward and through. Keep your back heel high. Inhale, reach arms up. As you exhale, gentle cactus arms. Soft around your neck and shoulders. Legs stay strong and stable. Inhale, reach and lift and lengthen. As you exhale, your hands go back. Belly button in. Pull your hands back. Continue. Reach your hands higher than your hip line. Core stays tight. So when your arms go back up, your back knee slowly comes down at the same time. So it's inhale, back knee down, arms up. Exhale, reach arms down behind you, interlace your fingertips. Press your palms tightly together. Lift your chest, lift your chin. Maybe this is your stopping point. Maybe slowly begin to lean back. For three. Slow and steady, lift your heart. Reach your arms up. As you exhale, hands go back. Back knee lifts, core tight. For three. For two. Arms out like airplane wings, inhale. Exhale, twist, left hand goes down, right arm reaches out and up. Pull your right hip back, lift and look up for three. For two, inhale. Exhale, right hand down, strong arm, step back, high plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale to upward facing dog. Exhale, drop back, downward facing dog. Pause to take a deep breath. Inhale, your left leg floats up, point through your toes. Lift it nice and high and strong and straight. Exhale, step it forward and through. Back leg stays nice and strong. Inhale, reach your arms up. Soften through your shoulders, belly in. Front leg nice and strong. Inhale. As you exhale, hands reach back. Belly in tight. Engage. Draw the shoulders down and back. Engage. Keep the back leg strong. We're going to lift back up here. Taking those cactus arms, inhale, lift up. Exhale, cactus arms. Melt your shoulders away from your neck and your ears. Inhale, bring it back up. Core tight. Exhale to your thunderbolt. Hands back, heart forward, belly in. We got an extra one on that side. Remember, using your breath and the connection to your body working as a whole. So as you inhale, back knee goes down, arms lift up, inhale. Exhale, reach arms out and down behind you. Interlace and even try to switch your grip to a non-habitual grip. So it might feel a little awkward. Squeeze. Now pull back until your arms get as straight as they can and even hover the bone away from your back leg. Lift your heart, lift your chin. Maybe this is intense enough. Just breathe. Take an inhale. Maybe you're exhale, you begin to lean back. Take another deep breath. Inhale, lift your heart back. Reach your arms up. Core strong. Inhale. Exhale as your hands go back. Back knee lifts. Hold for three. For two. Inhale, reach arms out like airplane wings. Exhale, twist over towards the left side. Right arm goes down. Left arm reaches up. Left hip pulls back. Back heel forward. Breathe for three. Reach belly in for two. Inhale. Exhale, left hand down. Step it back, high plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale to upward facing dog. Exhale, drop back, downward facing dog. Hold and breathe for three. Rising high, your tiptoes look forward. Stepping your left and then your right foot forward. Lengthen halfway up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reverse one of all but reach and lift up. Exhale, your hands to your heart. Take a deep, calm breath. Inhale. Exhale. So nice and gently, begin to shift your body weight into your right leg. And you're going to lift your left knee up. Foot flexed. Now reach your arms out and up. As you exhale, you're going to sweep your left arm underneath your right. Finding eagle arms. Lift up through your elbows. Soften with your shoulders. Begin to cross your left leg up and over the right. Maybe the legs cross, maybe once, maybe they cross twice. And then try to align your knees and your elbows in one straight line. Notice how the bottom torso wants to twist. Try to pull that left hip back. Lift through the arms, lift through your heart. Inhale. Squeeze your center line, then can you sit and slide straight down? Breathe, five. Core tight, four. Three. I'm going to turn to the side. Keep with your eagle arms. Take an inhale. Exhale, begin to reach your heart forward as you unravel that left leg and kick it back. Extend and lengthen. Pull your belly button up. Reach and kick. Point through your left toes. For three. For two, you're stepping back to warrior one legs. Take time to readjust here. Readjust into nice strong warrior legs. Push with that back quad. Lift through the elbows. Soften your shoulders. Now reach up with the fingertips. Look up. Take an inhale. Exhale, maybe gently lean back. Holding for three. Bend deeper into that right leg. For two. Inhale, spine up. Core tight. Let that back heel pivot up. We're coming out the way we came. So slowly hinge forward. Try not push off the back leg like that, but you want to shift so far forward to that front foot that all you do is power and stand in flat. Holding for five. Yes, we're coming back to eagle. Four. Smile and breathe for three, two, left leg begins to lift, wrap it up and over the right, find your eagle nice and calm, five, sit lower, inhale, unravel, stand tall, inhale, reach up, exhale your hands to your heart, close your eyes, be still. For three. Noticing how your right side body feels compared to your left. Maybe a little bit more lightness on one side. More prana, that life flow and energy. Big breath in. Side out, let it go. Then opening your eyes, lock your gates. Shift all of your body weight into the left leg. Lift your right knee up, foot flex, leg strong. Reach your arms out and up. You're sweeping your left arm underneath the right, finding your eagle legs, find your balance, belly in, soften your shoulders, inhale. Maybe that right knee lifts higher until you begin to bend into that left leg, wrapping it up and over. Maybe it's just wrapping once with your inner thighs, maybe twice with the ankles. Now pull your right hip back, aligning your knees underneath your elbows. Lift your elbows up, lean back a little bit. Inhale, squeeze your thighs and your glutes as you exhale, sit lower. Five. Core tight. Smile on your face, breathe. And we're kicking it out to that warrior three variation. Take an inhale. Exhale, you're gonna reach forward as you unravel that right leg. Reach and kick back. Reach and kick. Hold, five, four, maybe point to those right toes, reach, three, belly up, two, reach and step that right foot back, find your warrior legs, readjust, keep a nice deep strong bend in that front leg, lift your elbows, lift your gates, relax your shoulders, lift your heart, inhale, exhale, maybe begin to lean back. Bend deeper into the left leg. Breathe. Five. Stay with your breath. Inhale, bring it back up. Let your back heel lift. Lean forward. Remember, find power in your front leg. Don't bend the back leg and push from it. You want to find power in the front leg. High to your right to toes. Power to your left leg. Begin to fly to right. Reach your hands and your heart forward. Hold it here for five. Four. Woo. Three. Reach. Two. Slowly draw that right knee up. Nice and high. Then wrap up and over. Find your eagle. Take your time. Lift your arms higher. Lean back. Now sit deeper. Three. Smile on your face. Breathe it in. For two. Slow and steady. Begin to unravel. Reach your arms up. Look up. Exhale your hands to your heart. Close your eyes. Breathe it out for three. Big inhale. Let it go. Arms down by your sides. Check in with your feet. Make sure you're in a nice, strong, stable Tadasana Mountain Pose. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lengthen halfway up. You're gonna step or float back to your chaturanga. Inhale to up dog. Exhale, drop back, downward facing dog. Flow your right leg up nice and strong. Put in the effort on the lift. And then exhale, step into the pinky side of your right hand. Readjust that back foot back a little bit. Find some more length in your spine and just go forward and back. And then keep your weight forward and then let your left knee go down. Untuck your toes, extend your heart forward again. Relax and lengthen through your neckline. If you want to progress on this and take it a little bit deeper, yes, you can drop down to your elbows, but don't let that change your breath. Even more of a progression here. Can you press so firm to the top of your left toes that your back knee lifts? Yes, to the top of your toes. Five. If your back knee is lifted, let it come back down. If you are onto your elbows, you can stay there. If not, you're staying to the left hand. Pivot your right foot out. Let your hips sink a little bit more. Reach that right arm high. Reach straight back. Maybe you can bend into that left leg, reach back and catch. If you're all the way to your elbow and you're like, oh, I can't reach, come back onto your hand and lift your chest up until you can. So obviously this is a little bit more intense because it's drawing deeper on your hip flexors. If it feels better to look down, feel free. Hold and breathe for five. Nice and gently let go of that back foot if you have it, circling that right arm forward and down. Coming back up onto your hands, bring to your elbows, and heel to your right foot back to the outer edge of your right arm. So all five toes are facing forward, and just ease out of the left hip flexors as you pull back, flex to that right foot. Push forward as you inhale. Exhale, pull back. So you're gonna push forward, but don't sink all the way forward. Leave some room underneath that right glute, and you're gonna try to reach your right arm through. So if you're all the way up towards the elbow, that's okay, but that's where you kind of stop and work on reaching your heart forward. Because you don't want to be on the back of your elbow. You want to be more to the back of your tricep or shoulder. And now press firm into your front foot. Can you begin to take your right hand to the back of your right hip? Maybe that left arm reaches out and back. And go for a bind. Option one, you stay here. Keep working open on your chest and shoulders. Option two, back toes tuck and lift your back knee. Five. Take another deep breath. If your back knee lifted, gently release it down. Release your arms. Bring your heart back up. Exhale, slowly begin to draw your hips back once again. Both hands and your spine is to the inside of that right leg. Gently reach and forward fold. If you want to sway it out a little bit here, sway it out. Bring your hips back to center. Sink a little bit deeper. Open up to the hip and the hamstrings at the same time. So if your tightness is in your lower back, think about, this is where you kind of want to stay. If your tightness is in your hamstrings, your hips, you may want to stay here instead of going for the arm balance. So if that's you, stay here and enjoy the extra amount of time to stretch. If you want to play with your arm balance, you lift your heart, you begin to push your hips forward. And now we're working on opening up. So again, option one, you stay right here, work on that stretch. Option two, you're gonna slide that right arm underneath again. This time you're heel-toeing your foot towards center. So we are going into our running man pose. Hide those right tip toes. tuck your right shoulder under as much as you can. So this is phase one of see if you can kind of heel toe that right foot forward until you can toe tap. That's how strong your adductors have to be, your hip strength. And then maybe you need to pull that right heel back, tuck the left foot under lip, and you connect your left elbow. Your teeter totter forward, reaching your heart and your head forward. So to progress on that, you want the front leg straight. So you set it up again, and then you lift that back leg, straight forward, lift. 3, 2, if you have a vinyasa, take it. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, drop back. Ooh, downward facing dog. Take a deep breath. Inhale, side out, let it go. Put in effort with the lift of your left leg. As you inhale, lift your left leg up. Exhale, step it forward and through. Nice strong core. And as you exhale, gently drop that back knee down. Hands to inside that left leg. Left foot is to the pinky side of your left hand. Let your hips sink for a moment. Let the back toes just relax. Let your heart reach forward, shoulders back, neck long. Again, this may be intense enough for you on the front of your right hip flexor, so you can stay here, or to intensify, you can drop down to your elbows. It's more important to have a deep breath, so it's always about the depth and the quality of your breath, not the pose, so breath comes first. So if you cut off your breath, and you end up like this and you can't talk, it's better to be up here. And then slowly bring it forward and down. Try to keep your left knee directly on top of your heel. So check in, if it's not, readjust. And again, one more progression here. If you want to, press so firm to the top of your back foot that it lifts your back knee. Heart forward, 5. Find some strength at peace, 4. Nice and gently release that back knee if it lifted. If you're onto your elbows, you can stay there, but remember you can always come back up onto your hands. Shift your weight over to that right arm, whether it's the elbow or the palm, and then reach your left arm out and up, heel to that left foot up a little bit, and begin to bend into the back leg, reach back and catch your pinky toe side. Hold and breathe, 5. Relax your hips and glutes. One more deep breath. Nice and soft, you begin to release. Bring yourself back up onto your hands. Heel to the left foot, back towards center until all 5 toes face forward, but your hands are both still to the inside of that left leg. And now just begin to pull your hips back, flexing through your left foot. If you need to shift forward and back a few times to help flush them out, feel free. And the next time your hips are back, keep it there. Front foot flex, reach your heart forward. And then just soften through your neckline. Maybe sway out your hips to help release. And then find your hips at center, maybe lift a little bit, finding more space. And then exhale, hinge and forward fold. Hold it here. Breathe for 5. Softly lifting your spine. So remember, if you're here more for flexibility, then I recommend just kind of staying here in this nice, deep, long stretch just to work a little bit more time and breaths on your flexibility. If you want more strengthening, then we're going to play with that arm balance. It's flexibility too, but it's adding more strength components to it. So you shift the hips forward, and now you're going to begin to work that left arm through. Power into that left leg. We're working the opening of our chest and shoulders first, so that bind. So again, if you're still want stretching and opening, you can do this too. And then that left arm reaches up behind you towards your lower back, towards your left hip. Right arm reaches out. And now wrap and go for that bind. This is option one. Option two, your back toes tuck and your back knee lifts. Notice how it pulls your heart forward. You want to lift it up. Hold, five, four, three, two. If your back knee is lifted, gently release it down. Release your arms. Bring it back up. If you're pausing here for flexibility, pull it back again. Go into that nice deep long stretch and that's where you'll stay. If you're going more for the balance and strengthening, hips go forward again. Dip that left shoulder underneath again. Get as low as you can. Now heels for your left foot more to the side. It's gonna squeeze into your shoulder. Notice how rounded my back is. You wanna reach your heart forward. Now maybe tuck your back toes under and lift the back knee. See what happens there. Maybe begin to toe tap forward. Maybe begin to slide that left heel back to help. Dropping that right elbow into the hip and then shift your heart forward and lift. If you wanna go for a straight leg, try to work that left leg as high onto the back of your shoulder as you can. Reach it forward, five, four, three. If you have a vinyasa, take it. Inhale to your up dog. Exhale, drop back, downward facing dog. Woo! Give yourself a big breath in. Sigh out. Nice and softly, release your knees. Let your hips open. You're gonna allow your palms to be facing up as you relax your forehead down. Gently rock your chin from side to side. Relax and release your neck. And let your head settle back into center. Deep inhale. Exhale, side out. Nice and gently. Begin to shift your body weight forward again, hands underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips, just tuck your toes under, draw back to your downward facing dog. Holding it here for five. Keep your neck nice and relaxed, your hands are strong. Four more deep breaths. Last two. Rise high on your tiptoes, look forward. Focus on the pinky sides of your hands. You're gonna bend into your knees and hop to the pinky sides of your hands. So you're coming right into Malasana Garland Pose, hands to your heart, and then lift your heart up to your hands. Relax and drop your shoulders back. Try to get your spine as tall as possible. Belly pulling back into your spine. Breathing for three. And you still continue to calm down your breaths. What are your intentions in this moment? Are your thoughts pure? Do these thoughts and intentions serve you well in this moment? For a moment, can you keep your heart high, but extend your arms forward, thumbs facing out, heart lifts. Try not round and drop, but push and lift for three. Make your hands seal towards your third eye for two. Inhale. Exhale your hands to your heart. If you need your hands, of course, use them behind you. If you don't, glutes come down, legs together. Coming into your boat pose, Navasana. Extend your arms forward, palms facing up. Draw your knees in tight. If you want to straighten, feel free to straighten, but lift up higher. Chest up, chin up, smile, five. Let every breath grow a bigger smile, four. Makes everything a little bit easier and more fun. Three. Two. You're going to drop your body back into your cloud pose. So as the back goes back, legs go up and over. Of course, modified version. You can just bring your spine to the mat. Slightly place your hands underneath your glutes and just allow the legs to kick up. We're holding it here for five.
4, 3, 2. Slowly begin to release your spine down. Hug just your right knee in. Hug it in. Drop your shoulders back. And now keep your right knee in tight as you slowly lower that left leg. And then relax it down. Roll out your ankles clockwise and counterclockwise. Now flex both feet. Keep your right leg in tight. Lift that left leg back up. Hold on to the back of your right leg. Kick your right leg up. Maybe you can balance out the legs. Pull the right leg in more. Keep it there. Release the left leg back down. Hold and breathe for 5. Last 2. Keep that tight grip. Slowly lift your left leg back up. Core engage. Cross your right leg over the left. Not quite eagle legs, it's just inner thighs. So think of Supta Gomukhasana, which is a reclined cow face pose. So you can round up, reach and catch, and go to the tops of your ankles or your shins. Your legs are at a V. And then just let your heels sink down towards your glutes. If it feels better to kick them out, that's okay too. Getting into your hips here, just try to feel a little opening through your outer hips and glutes. Breathing it out. 5 more breaths here. Good, relax your back. So you're gonna try to keep this grip that you have on the tops of your shins or toes to take it into a reclined half lotus pose. So keep that grip, let your heels sink in. Your left knee and hip will drop open first. And then try to pull that left heel or right heel on top of your left hip and slowly drop that right hip open. If your legs will stay, feel free to reach your arms up overhead and hold to opposite elbows. Hold and breathe. 5. Breathe into the stillness, into the silence. If your arms are up overhead, just slowly begin to slide them down towards your legs, and your hands will help support your knees back up into your chest. Once you hug it in, take a gentle rock from side to side. And then once back at center, flex your feet and drive your legs straight up to the ceiling. Back is flat, shoulders are back. Keep your right leg extended, you're just hugging the left knee in. Sink your lower back down, take an inhale. Keep that tight grip of your left leg as you slowly lower the right down. And then let it relax. Roll out your ankles clockwise and counterclockwise. And then let your legs relax, breathing for 3. Relax your back, relax your neck. And then flex both feet, core engaged. Slowly lift your right leg back up. Straight up from your hip line, so if the leg needs to be bent, that's okay a little bit. And now drive the left leg back up, holding at the back of your leg. Try to push from your quads. Draw your shoulders back. If you have a little bit more flexibility, draw your left leg closer towards you. Now keep it there. Slowly, with control, lower that right leg down. And then relax. Breathe. 5. Engage your core. Flex your feet. Gently lift your right leg back up. Now cross your left leg over it, bend into the legs. And then round your spine up just to reach and catch the tops of your shins, your ankles, maybe your toes. And then see how it feels to recline back and then let your heels either relax down towards your glutes or maybe do get a deeper stretch by kicking them out. You choose which one feels better to you. And you're just gonna find that position, whichever one felt better, and hold. Taking big expansive belly breaths just to feel a widening sensation at your hips. Four. Big breaths. Three. So try to keep that grip on top of your shins or your toes. Remember, we're taking it to a reclined half lotus. So slowly let your right hip and knee drop open first. Try to pull your left foot a little bit higher on top of your right hip and then slowly let your left hip open. You can either keep the grip on your feet or slowly flow your arms up overhead. Feel free to hold to opposite elbows. Relax your back. Five deep breaths. One more full breath in. Your arms are up overhead, just slowly slide them and release them down, guiding your knees together. Hugging your knees in, taking that gentle rock from side to side. And then pausing back at center. So either A, plant your feet down and plant your palms down and take a gentle lift of your hips. Maybe begin there, just kind of see how you feel. So option one is to hold this. Option two is to take it into that full back bend into your wheel pose where your arms go up, your hands plant down, your hips lift up. Little trick, bring the crown of your head down first and then walk your hands back and then push and lift. Hold and breathe for five. Last two. Inhale. Exhale, slowly lower down. Lay your hips come down. Hands to your hips, knees together. Heel toe your feet apart. Relax your back. And then gently windshield wipe your legs out. Whether they're gentle, small windshield wipers, or maybe they go all the way from side to side. And then bring it all back into center, knees together, heel toe your feet together. And then gently hug it in. Round your spine up. And as you exhale, relax your spine all the way down, release your legs all the way out. Setting up for stillness for your final pose, Shavasana, so be comfortable. How quickly can you commit to that stillness? Take a deep breath in. Let it all go. Feel your body melting. Inhale. And gently let it go. Big breath in. Let it all go. Allow your body to be still, your mind to be calm and quiet. Your body. the stillness, these positive feelings throughout your body. Allow your mind to absorb the quiet, the calm, the silence. Connecting to samadhi, a state of bliss. And without disturbing that feeling of bliss, come back to the intention of this moment, the intention of your thoughts, living in this moment with purpose. And bring that with you as you slowly begin to bend into your knees, rolling onto your right side into the fetal position. And then gently begin to press your spine up, staying calm. Hands to your heart. With a slight tuck of your chin, bow of your head. With intention, with purpose. The divine light within me honors, respects, and bows to the divine light within you. That light that is made up of love and truth and beauty and peace. And when we are in this space, we are united, we are connected, and we are all one. Namaste. Thank you all so, so very much for joining. I hope you have a beautiful rest of your day. Much love, peace, and gratitude for you all.